Last time on Danganronpa V3, Killing Harmony. Yo, all it would take is like turn Kyo into a girl. Cross-dressing Kyo art. Please do not send me any if there is any. I will discover it on my own. That sounds even weirder when I say it like that. Yeah, let's just leave it at that.
Hey guys, Raiden here, and welcome back to Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony. So I know, once again, I've been away for a little bit. I'm not going to explain it. Just check out the last update video if you want to know why. But I was actually going to record this yesterday, but one of you guys told me on Twitter, like, do you have the love key or whatever yet? And I'm like, what are you talking about? And I figured out, as you told me, that if you get 10,000 of these coins, you can buy this key of love. Apparently it's easier later on when harder difficulties of the casino open up and you're allowed to bet more. But I saved up enough just to get this key, so let's grab that. Seeing everyone's labs is actually pretty cool. I didn't expect to be able to see every single one. I thought maybe it was going to be like, each of you go to your own, and then we're going to see like Kaede's and maybe Suichi's, but I didn't think we're going to be able to see all of them. And having all of this open up at once, they're a little scary, but I'll try it. Wait, what's a little scary? That message popped up and disappeared before I could do anything. Stairs, it looks like I can go to the third floor from here. Wait, Suichi, why are you scared of the stairs? They're like brightly colored pink. Then again, I guess so is blood in this game, so what does that mean, that pink is red in this game and that everything pink is colored like blood? I'm unsure. Whoa, what's with this video game door? What's this? It looks like a door, but I see, it's just a painting of a door. It looks like a video game. I think this is called pixel art. Wait, it's not even real? Oh, her room's back here. I think this is Tenko's. From the look of this door, it must be an ultimate research lab. I've no idea what kind, though. I should take a look inside. As I reach my hand to the doorknob.
Stop it.
I did not give you... Oh, it's children. That's what it was. I thought it was like a sumo wrestler on the front. Sorry, Maki. Didn't mean to... Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry. I did not give you permission to enter. Maki. So this is the ultimate child caregiver's lab. You wouldn't think so, judging
That's
by the
true.
Door. You're right, goodbye. But wait, can I look inside for a bit? No.
Huh?
But what? But there's a rule against people going- But there's no rule against people going to each other's labs.
I don't know.
I don't care about the rules, I'm not letting anyone inside. But what's-
hey!
Huh? What's going on? Oh, Kokichi, what are you even doing here? And how does she intend to keep everyone out of the room? That would mean that she would have to stand watch at all hours. Hey, what's going on? You guys are in the middle of a tiff now, are you? See, thanks to you, an annoying brat showed up.
Because?
You hear that, Suichi? An annoying brat has showed up, all because of you.
Okay.
Yeah.
So?
So, what's up? You don't want anyone to enter your lab, Maki? Don't be so pushy, Suichi. It's not good to do stuff that'll make a girl upset, you know. All you do is make people upset. Okay, I understand. Good, then stay away. If you try to go inside, it will be extremely painful. For you. Painful? I'm gonna rip your hoge off your head. That is painful. They might die if that happens.
Well, you know.
It's not good to do stuff that'll make a girl upset, you know.
But
still, doesn't it bug you that she won't let us in? I wonder why. What could even be in the child caregiver room? Like a bunch of fake children? That's the only thing I could think of. Like, a lot of these rooms have no actual application. Like, Gonta's bug lab does, but like the maid training room and the what seems to be the child caregiver room, it doesn't really make much sense. Let's see what Ryoma's up to. And look at this door. This must be an ultimate research lab. Based on this design, this might be the ultimate tennis pros lab. Maybe, Suichi, maybe it is. What would be in there? Probably rackets and training equipment. An entire indoor tennis court. This is impressive. Oh my goodness, the robots are playing tennis by themselves. This is the future. Wait, what the hell's the point in having a robot that plays tennis? Is it to have an opponent or what? But then you... I don't understand what's going on here. Why is Miyu in here? I guess she'd be interested seeing as how her inventions and such are... But I just saw her downstairs. An entire indoor tennis court. This is impressive. Hi, Miyu, what you doing here? Well, I accidentally clicked between Miyu's legs. A tennis net. It's stretched tight and looks sturdy. He's trying to look at Miyu.
Hey!
Oh, now this is an interesting machine. An interesting machine? You mean the one swinging the racket? With a few mods, that bad boy will look real good. Yeah, my creative juices are flowing.
So good.
Big metal arm.
I don't know what you're thinking of. Coming from her, it has to be inappropriate, but I have a bad feeling about this. Ryoma, do not let her in this room. She will do bad things to your machines, and you will not want to touch anything in here. Does Ryoma even want to play tennis? I mean, it's how he murdered someone.
This must be your lab, right, Ryoma? It must be nice having a whole tennis court here.
I don't care. I have nothing to do with tennis anymore.
Nothing to do with tennis?
Hey!
Ryoma, are you really not going to play tennis anymore?
What was that?
Tennis? Who the hell plays a hoity-toity sport like tennis?
Sure.
Oh, that's right. I totally forgot. You're a tennis player, aren't you?
I threw away my past.
It's fine if you forget. That was a long time ago. I swear, the number one thing Ryoma says is that was a long time ago.
So when you killed a mafia with your badass tennis skills, what was that a long time ago, too?
Wait!
Hey, come on,
what
Mew.
What was that?
What, it really happened, yeah?
No. Yeah, it's true. Thanks to that, even if I escape from here, I'll just go straight to a different prison. So it'd be meaningless for someone like me to play tennis now.
Then why are you staring at the tennis court with such sad eyes, Ryoma? Are you a little bitch? Because you're acting like a little bitch right now.
What's
with the stare down? You're scaring me. Okay then, well, Miyu's being as insensitive as always. Ryoma's trying to be deep. Is there a closet or something in the back?
Oh.
There's a shower room in the back.
Shower room. Why don't you boys go in and give each other a good scrub down? You're already the perfect height, Ryoma. Oh, God. You'll be lined up just right when you turn around and face Suichi.
What?
I was just kidding. I thought you'd laugh.
Miyu, some people are not down for most jokes. I mean, Kaede told a joke earlier and he was pretty down, but
not that one. Sure, I'll leave.
I think that's all we can explore, because Maki won't let us in her room.
Yahoo!
Oh, it's Angie.
Yahoo, I found you, Suichi.
You check out that weird flashlight thing?
I didn't know you were here. I've been looking for you everywhere.
Angie, did you find out anything about the flashlight?
Yep, I finally figured it out. Seems like Atua wants us to gather in the gym for an explanation.
Sayonara!
You don't have time to relax right now, Bayonara.
I swear, Bayonara is the most adorable thing ever. If Atua is going to explain it to us, I'm guessing she didn't figure it out. But in any case, I should go to the gym. Literally, this game's like any excuse possible for people to go to the gym. It feels weird. Oh wait, this isn't the gym, this is that weird room. Feels weird because I haven't done any... That room looks ominous. I never looked above the door to see this entire checkerboard and cross motif above it, but... There's something serious going on in that room, that's all I know. But, it feels weird having, like, coming back and haven't done voices in, like, a week or so. Because, even doing the Neffy voice is hurting. Not really hurting, it's just awkward. Hey guys, what's up?
Everyone!
Everyone gather around.
Prayer time.
We all hear good. Then let's bow our heads and pray to Atua.
Bitch.
You're a real pain in the ass, you know that? Just tell us what you fucking want.
Yeah, see?
Alrighty then, check this out.
What's the matter?
So this is a peculiar looking flashlight, so what of it?
I don't know what it is either. I inspected it pretty good.
Yeah!
But in the end, I couldn't figure it out, because I'm silly.
You couldn't?
How divine!
So I asked someone for help!
Could it be...
You don't mean... Are you... Angie, goddammit.
Leave it to Monokuma!
If something has you worried, just let Monokuma take care of it. If you don't know something, I'll tell you. If you need help, I'll tell you. I'll help you.
Hey.
If you don't like something, I'll fix it, so don't get rid of it. Please don't get rid of me.
Very bad when lady who act like that preys on you.
Huh? Do you know that from personal experience?
Yoo-hoo.
Tell us, Monokuma, what's his flashlight?
Yeah?
Why, that's a... Flashback light.
Oh.
A flashback light?
Huh?
Flashback?
My.
Light?
Hey,
That flashlight doesn't shed light on the darkness. It sheds light on your lost memories.
Hey. Lost memories?
Yeah.
You guys seem concerned that you don't remember how you came to this school. But if you use that flashback light, you can remember everything.
Huh?
What's with this light?
Yeah.
Man, this is weird. I haven't done any of these voices or, like, YouTubed anything in, like, a week, and it's just so... Oh, my goodness. Need to never do that again. So it's your fault we don't remember when we were kidnapped, huh?
May I?
What did you do to us, and how did you steal our memories away?
And another thing.
Maybe if you use the flashback light, like I keep hinting at, you'll be able to remember that, too.
This is stupid.
I don't believe it. No way this flashlight will recover our memories.
Yeah.
I bet there were a lot of naysayers and skeptics when the telephone was invented, too.
Hey,
For your information, the flashback light can treat various symptoms of memory loss. The light stimulates the basal ganglia and hippocampus. Not just that, but physical.
Ew,
I didn't realize how boring it would be to explain, but basically it works like that.
Thank you. I suck at everything science. Hey, don't just give up on explaining after a single sentence.
What should we do?
So, what should we do? What should we do? You mean, should we or should we not use the flashlight?
No.
No way, I refuse. It reeks of fishiness.
Mm. Yeah, Gonta no can believe flashlight can bring back memory.
Well,
why not ask someone who knows machines? We've got the ultimate inventor right here.
You're all a bunch of ultimate dumbasses. No fucking way that thing can treat amnesia. Then again, these aren't exactly normal circumstances.
Well. So in such an uncanny environment as this, common sense has no place.
Well, I mean, there are those neutralizer or neuralizer things, the flashy things from Men in Black.
Well.
Wow. We've been very vague about references till now, but I guess that one's just open. Are you talking about a movie? This is real life.
Yes.
You're right, I'm sorry.
I don't like that.
I don't think we should do it. I'm scared. It might cause some weird side effects.
Wow, actually, okay, I think I'm onto something with Kokichi, finally.
Yeah, I'm worried how it'll affect my magic.
All of you.
Has everyone spoken? If we are in accord, I will consent as well.
Then.
What about you, Shuichi? You have not said anything yet.
Huh?
What?
Alright!
Alright, let's decide it. Let's use it. I didn't say anything,
what?
Though.
Huh? Who decided that? We're all saying how dangerous it sounds.
Jeez, you guys are way too cautious. I mean, I understand why. We're in such a weird situation after all.
But you know...
We can't win just by running away. All the time. What?
Listen up.
If you want to win, you gotta be a little reckless sometimes. If we can't face this danger, there's no way we'll be able to defeat Monokuma.
Well, aren't you confident? But you've no idea how we're supposed to win, do you?
Yeah, I've got no clue, but still.
Let's do it!
If you want to win, you gotta make a stand somewhere, you'll never move forward. If we run away, our kids will grow up to be the kind of people who run away from things like this.
I don't understand.
I would hope my children would run away from something like this.
Huh? What are you talking about?
If you still want to run away, then go ahead. I won't stop you or blame you.
Okay, fine then. Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? What's wrong, everyone? Aren't we going? I'm staying.
Listen up!
After hearing that degenerate speech, running away would just frustrate me.
Going to also stay is what true gentlemen would probably do.
Probably? Really?
100%.
I also agree with Kaito. Our defeat is 100% assured unless we stand up to this. That's how I feel, deep inside, just a whisper. You hear it in your ghost? I'm pretty sure robots don't have ghosts,
that
though.
It's not funny.
Leave me alone.
I shall stay as well. I suspect I will be able to observe something most interesting.
On your knees!
If anything happens to me, y'all better beg my fans, the world, and humanity for forgiveness.
Hey!
So what are you gonna do, Shuichi?
Okay.
I'll stay behind, too.
Got it.
All right.
Right?
I'll stay too. So what if it might cause some weird side effects? It's no big deal.
It seems as if...
It seems everyone agrees with Kaito. Very well, I shall follow suit.
Now it's decided. Hurry up and do
Woo-hoo!
It.
I'm gonna turn it on!
Yeah!
How the frick do I turn this thing on?
She throws it against the wall.
Man, I hate technology. Just pray to a Tua.
Yeah, please.
Click.
Click.
At that moment Angie flicked on the light. The world warped. Whoa. Was that Kaede's eyes? Looked like it. Oh, this is the same thing that happened in the intro sequence. A lightning bolt in my mind shattered my consciousness like shrapnel. Like a video in fast forward, scenes played out in the back of my head, when the pieces of my sight had gathered together again. Oh no. The fact that everyone's remembered something is not going to bode well. This really is not going to go well at all.
I remember
now. Oh. It's not as bad as it looks. I mean, the fact there's like a billion people chasing after Shuichi. Sure, that's an exaggeration, but okay.
I was running away. I had been running this entire time. From the ultimate hunt.
The ultimate hunt. Bloodborne.
Those of us with ultimate talents were hunted down. It wasn't safe anywhere. Oh.
I did not expect to come across any plot thing like this. An ultimate hunt?
Eventually, I had no place else to run. I was cornered, and to escape from the ultimate hunt, I threw away my ultimate talents to live as a normal high school student.
How do you do that?
By erasing my talent and my memories, I no longer had any reason to be hunted.
What? So he was able to just erase his talent?
If I didn't do what I did, I would have been captured, a fate worse than death. And so I chose. I chose to gamble on a new technology developed in a particular facility. The technology that could put your memories to sleep by controlling your brain waves.
You know what, that room I was talking about that was next to the gym? I bet that room may have something to do with that, just the way it looks.
I used that to hibernate all memories relating to my talent.
That's it!
Yes, I remember everything now. In order to escape the ultimate hunt, I erased my own memory.
Well, wait, did you just say ultimate hunt?
Huh? Really?
You guys too? So it wasn't just me getting chased down in this ultimate hunt.
I do not agree.
Yes, you are not the only one. I know we were being chased as well.
We? What does we mean? We looked around at one another, each of us with the same shocked expression. What Kirumi said was true. We were all the same. We were all running from the ultimate hunt. Oh, she just meant all of us in general.
In other words,
all of us were being chased by the ultimate hunt. What on earth does that mean?
Oh wait, can someone tell me what this is? I can't seem to remember. What is the ultimate hunt?
Jeez, how could you forget something so important? Alright guys, the ultimate hunt is... totally not gonna remember, is he?
What?
Huh? What is it? What was it? Why can't I remember? I can't either. I suddenly realized I could not remember any important details of the ultimate hunt.
How?
It's no use, I can't remember either. I can only remember being chased. I can't remember anything else at all. Yeah, no matter how hard I try, I can't seem to remember.
I don't want to live. I want to die with everyone else.
What was that? I want to die with everyone else? I remember saying that, but why did I say it? It's no use. I can't remember either.
God damn it!
This feels gross, like a shit that won't fully squeeze out. Ew.
However,
even if we can't remember, we should still be able to figure something out.
Huh? What do you mean?
If we were all running from the ultimate hunt, then why were we imprisoned here?
Why?
Huh, why?
Could it be
the reason that we were caught by the ultimate hunt? Caught by the ultimate hunt?
You mean we tried to escape by erasing our memories, but they found us anyway. And subsequently, we were captured as part of this ultimate hunt.
No.
Then this killing game is...
Yeah.
Yeah, it might be the work of the ultimate hunt.
Let's see.
Is that so? Then I am all the more concerned about this ultimate hunt.
But
how disappointing. No one can remember anything. Nyahaha! What a disappointing disappointment.
Piece of shit!
Quit laughing about this, you little shit.
It
seems losing him made a far bigger impact than we expected. Losing him? Who's him?
Huh?
Him?
Yes.
Rantaro. He seemed to know more than he let on. Hey, I have a question. This might sound a little weird, but... Does the term Ultimate Hunt ring a bell? Oh, that's right, he did talk about that. I completely forgot about that. Which means that Kaede may have made the situation like a billion times worse for us than it needed to, so...
Oh!
Oh, I do sort of remember him saying something like that.
Our mild-mannered mystery man said that, huh?
But
then why did only Rontaro remember the ultimate hunt?
Listen.
There is no point in discussing that now. After all, he is already dead. But if you truly wish to hear his words, I could perform a seance for you.
Don't screw around!
So stop it. Wait, what's a seance? Stop it. Don't bring up weird stuff like that. Why are you acting girly all of a sudden? That was girly.
Too bad.
I swear to God, if Korokiyo's actually a woman, we can transcend some barriers here. Yet death can be real heartless.
Why you?
Says the root of all evil. Looks like you guys safely got your memory back. What the hell's going on, you stupid bear? This ultimate hunt makes no goddamn sense. Looks like your sealed memories are more stubborn than I thought. Just use one of the flashback light wasn't enough. Wait, just one use of the flashback light wasn't enough to restore all of your memories.
You got me.
You're such a terrible liar. You totally did that on purpose. What connection do you have with the ultimate hunt? Hoo-hoo-hoo, I can't reveal that. Regardless of my true identity, my goal is crystal clear.
Yahoo!
That is to make you guys participate in the killing game. That is my only desire.
The killing game. That's what it always comes back to.
You gotta be kidding me!
Well, what killing game? I'll never do that ever again.
Right. We just gotta work together. If we cooperate, we can make it out of here alive. Just like a certain someone said.
Kaede.
But...
That was a weird, like, nuance. It's just like someone writes Suichi, and Suichi's just over in the corner crying. He's like, Suichi, come on, we're over this shit now.
But I believe cooperating with each other is the most logical course of action.
I'm snoring.
Why are you sleeping?
What?
Hey, Kokichi, we're having a serious conversation here.
And it's written somewhere that I have to take serious conversations seriously?
Quit acting so immature.
I'm a teenager, so I'm immature. Aren't you guys forgetting to act your
what
age?
Is it?
But I don't have a biological age. Don't worry about it, Kibo. I'm just talking to the humans right now. What were we talking about again? Something about working together to escape? Alright. So you were listening, you horrible degenerate.
See?
We don't have to work together, though. Let's just ask how we can get
That's
out.
The point.
If we ask Monokuma, the only way is to win the killing game.
We really don't get it.
Oh, we're not gonna ask Monokuma. We're gonna ask the mastermind among us. What?
Why you?
Are you already going senile? I thought we agreed that there is no mastermind. Oh yeah, we did, didn't we? We tried to sniff out the mastermind again. We just repeat Kaede's screw-up.
You better quit messing around.
Huh?
You think I'm messing around right now?
Oh,
where'd the highlights in his hair go? Like, when he was scared, the highlights just disappeared. Oh man, you really don't get it. I'm trying to get this through to everyone. If you keep saying all this uplifting stuff about working together and cooperating, prepare for scary face. Oh, I guess not. Then you can expect to receive some painful retaliation, get
Wait.
It?
Wait!
What are you suggesting, Kokichi?
That's enough!
Alright, that's enough. I'm gonna
Whoa.
Slug him.
No, oh, he's gonna punch me. I gotta make a break for it. Kokichi said his piece and then dashed as fast as he could out of the room.
Damn, he's fast.
Sheesh.
Jeez, what a strange guy.
Jeez.
He just provokes people and never says anything from the heart. He's always messing around and making fun of those around him.
Huh, how can he say such insensitive things? We're trying so hard to survive.
It's like he doesn't even want to survive, though I guess I'm no different.
Huh?
What?
In other words...
Yeah, I don't plan to survive till the end. Well, that's depressing.
Ryoma.
You not plan to survive? What that mean?
He has mentioned that before. He has no real reason to live.
Yeah?
He doesn't have a reason to live.
What?
Poor Ryoma. It seems he's got a more tragic past than we could even begin to imagine.
I mean...
Yeah, but the ultimate tennis pro shouldn't be saying such cowardly stuff.
What do you think?
Perhaps we should relax over a meal? Everyone, could you please tell me your favorite foods and beverages?
Huh?
Pancakes! Pancakes! We know, Kyo, you ate all of them. There's literally none left in the facility. Huh? You're gonna whip up something out, Krumi? Are you like the perfect mom?
She is perfect mom. Everyone just calls her mom from now on.
After we finished the meal that Kurumi prepared for us, we decided to return to our rooms. Kurumi is best mom. I didn't actually look, like, thoroughly in any of the rooms for the Monocubs, because I figured we'd get a chance to later, so there's no point in doing so right now. There are hidden Monokumas around the Ultimate Academy. Maybe you've already seen one. You can collect the hidden Monokumas by investigating them. Your collection will be displayed on the shelf in this room, so get busy filling it. They're fun to look at when you want to take a break from everything. Anyway, what's the ultimate hunt? It's still bothering me. Why did Rantaro know? But I suppose I won't get anywhere thinking about it by myself. Time for action.
All right.
There's still some time left today. I think I need to think of a plan. Free time! And by think of a plan, you mean just talk to people and have fun? Okay, so to activate one of the special hidden scenes or whatever, I actually had to go back a bit. And what you guys told me to do is I should talk to her, see if I have a very specific item. What's wrong, Tenko? Angie said we should meet at the gym.
Yes. Yeah, I know, but I can't stop thinking about the pool. I wish I could swim. Especially when the pool of my dreams is right in front of me.
Wait, how can you not swim when you're like the ultimate Aikido master?
That's it!
Oh, wait, you can't swim, but maybe you can feel like a celebrity if you relax by the pool.
Huh? What's this degenerate male even talking about?
I love how it's not an insult anymore. It's just like, I'm talking to this person. This is their name now. That's what their title is. I don't think it's such a bad idea. See, you take a parasol and put it up by the pool and relax in the shade. You'll feel glamorous for sure.
Wow, that's a great idea. It didn't even cross my mind.
Well then, Suichi, please set up the parasol for me. We go with Tenko? Yeah, why not?
Okay.
All right, that's fine. Right. Yes, degenerate males should definitely know their place. Okay then, see you later. See you around, Tenko. She's not so bad once you get around to it. Well, I suppose it's not too much trouble. Why do I have to like all the characters? Well, I mean, there's some I like more than others, obviously, but like, why do they have to? It's not fair. I want them all to live for happily ever after, and now I have to play the whole gym section again, damn it. So, see you guys when we're done with the gym again. Okay, now we're back to here, and, we're gonna get that pool scene now. What's this? There's something at the pool. A beach chair and a table. Were these in the warehouse? With a parasol, this would definitely look like a celebrity's private pool. But who prepared all this? Did Tenko do it by herself? Oh, of course. She asked Kurumi for some help.
You're late, Suichi.
Huh?
Kurumi?
What do you think?
Did you bring the parasol?
Hmm.
I did, but wait, how do you know about that, Kurumi?
Yes.
Tenko informed me of her desire to feel like a celebrity at the pool, so I made some preparations.
I see. Thank you, Ultimate Mother.
That is correct.
I have placed tropical beverages and fruits in the refrigerator. God damn it. If you start to feel cold, I prepared warm meals which I can reheat over the stove. On the poolside, I have prepared oil massages.
Yes, of course.
In the changing room, I have prepared a variety of swimsuits to choose from.
What do you think?
Once the parasol is set, everything will be complete, whenever you are ready.
Okay.
Thanks. I kind of find it funny that everyone's so, like, gung-ho about finding a way out of here, but then we just spend all our free time just hanging out.
She did all that work? I feel kind of bad.
I did as Kurumi asked and set up the parasol and people started to arrive at the pool. Oh, I thought this was just going to be Tenko. Oh, it's, of course, Himiko would come too.
That's amazing!
Kurumi, thank you so much for preparing everything.
Yeah, thanks for doing everything.
I'm surprised you're the type of person that likes to go outside.
Thank you!
Thank you, Kurumi. I already have my swimsuit on.
I am grateful for your care, Kibo. You can't shut up. They don't have to know that.
It seems as if...
This is more people than I had been told.
I'm sorry!
I'm sorry. I just wanted Himiko to feel like a celebrity,
Yoo-hoo!
Too.
Can I join? Atua says he wants to feel like a celebrity, too.
If Atua wants to be a celebrity, then we might as well invite him, too.
Just sure, if that's what you want, Himiko.
Or I just wanted a vacation I just wanted a vacation like a celebrity with Himiko. Would a god want to be a celebrity?
Then shall I begin preparing for everyone else? Will that include you as well?
Huh?
Me too?
No. Oh, Suichi can't join. As a generic male, his only job was to help set this up.
But what about Kibo?
Yes.
Kibo's a robot, so he's neither male nor female. He barely passes.
I cannot tell if that is a robophobic, or if that remark is robophobic or not.
Okay.
Well, at the very least, you're better off than I am. By the way,
what
Kibo. Yes?
Excuse me.
In your case, do you prefer oil over tropical juice? That won't be necessary. I the offer alone is more than enough.
I do not agree.
Kibo, Tenko requested I help her feel like a celebrity, and she has included you as one of her guests. I will do my utmost to fulfill her request, for that is how a maid must conduct herself. So please, tell me what food or beverages I can prepare so you feel like a celebrity. Such pride and dedication, Kurumi's prowess a maid is showing. I do not require food, and I would not be able to taste in the first place. Let's go change our swimsuits. Suichi, you know what will happen if you peep, right? You don't have to tell me, I'm not gonna peep. I've never seen that one before. Oh, but you're welcome to peep. I'd love an excuse to exterminate a degenerate. Is that an invitation or not? Wow, that is some fan servicey stuff right there. Hold on, let me just... thumbnail right... No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to turn that into a thumbnail. Actually, you know what? I could probably turn part of this into a thumbnail. Himiko looks weird without her hat on. I can't even tell who that is. Kibo's looking like he's trying to figure out what a parasol even is. Suichi just is awkwardly laughing like, ha, I've never seen boobs in my life before. This is great. And then everyone else is having a good time. Kurumi's just being best mom. Miss Tenko, how's the oil massage? My whole body feels like it's melting.
Like it's
she's actually voice acting it.
Kurumi, more tropical punch, please.
Understood. I will also provide a fruit platter.
I'm so happy, Kurumi. You're making me feel like a pampered celebrity. My lifelong dream has finally come true.
There is no need to thank me. Your happiness is the reason I serve.
What a pain.
You're relaxing right now. What exactly is a pain?
Out of curiosity, do you really need that parasol even though we're indoors?
Of course! If you want to feel like a celebrity, you absolutely need a parasol. A robot like you wouldn't understand what it means to feel like a celebrity.
She looks better. She actually kind of looks better with her hair down like that. I love how Angie didn't even have to change, though. She's just like, yep, I wear a swimsuit all the time.
This is a difficult feeling to understand.
After attending the celebrities, I return to my room. Level up. Suichi's hormones allowed him to advance further in the ladder of humanity. Anyway, what's the ultimate hunt? Blah, 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 blah. Suichi, you just got to go to, like, a swimming pool with a bunch of girls who are way out of your league, and you're sitting here thinking about the ultimate hunt. Come on. There apparently is a second event, but it doesn't happen till after we're done with everything. So actually, before I even hang out with anyone, I want to go Monokuma doll hunting. So let's go. I have no idea where I'm going to find them. Oh, there's one right up there. I never noticed him. Hey there, little guy. Obtained hidden Monokuma. Yay, another one for me. I wonder, do any of them ever appear outside? Oh, is that one? I think I just found one. He's relaxing. Yes. Getting so lucky here. You know, this is actually the first time I don't think we've ever actually been in Miyu's lab before. Wait a minute, I see you. You can't hide from me. How do I get back there? I see you. I see you hiding. There's a bed in the middle of the room. It feels like an operating table where a mad scientist would perform human experiments. Oh, trust me, she's doing some other things on that table that have nothing to do with science. How do I hit things again? I see you behind there, but I don't know how to get to you. Oh. Yes. So lucky I decided to check out this lab. Obtained hidden Monokuma, it has angel wings. Oh my goodness, I came up here to talk to someone. And right where you start, there's a Monokuma right there. It's dragon wings. Wow, we're level 28 now. Okay, so before I actually go to talk to anyone like I was going to do, let's go back to the school store and I'm gonna spend some time at the Monokuma machine. And then I'll finally decide who I want to hang out with, because it's like Oh my goodness. It's super hard to decide who you want to spend time with in this game. There are so many people. A lot of which are girls and, debatable girl at this point. Oh, you know, I would also like to hang out with Gonta, too. Yeah, Gonta, Kibo, and, Kyo are most of the guys I would hang out with. Oh, the females. I don't think I'm too interested in hanging out with Himiko. So after, like, 6 minutes of debating who to hang out with, like, mentally, I kind of thought about it, and I'm hoping this game has, like, the after-school thing so you can see all the events, like, when the game ends. I'm not sure if you guys would be interested in seeing that. For now, let's hang out with Angie, because I want to know what the hell this girl even does all day. Like, she is a ray of sunshine, and I never see her actually doing anything. She just pops up out of nowhere and screams something about a Tua at me.
Ooh.
That flashlight was a flashback
so
light.
Divine.
A light that restores memory is simply divine. I bet a Tua had a hand in its creation.
Should I hang out with Angie for a while? Yes.
Right deal.
And let us pray you a Tua and thank him for restoring our memories.
Okay, yep, let's go pray to Atura, Angie, whatever you want to do. I swear, I'm writing like a nature documentary on this creature. I spent some time watching Angie pray to Atura. You know, Suichi would have like the perfect voice for a nature documentary.
Now we watch the wild Angie as she prays to Atura. That's it, it's 30 minutes of this shit. I don't know how she does this all day long.
Angie and I grew a little closer today, even though we didn't talk to each other at all. Would you like to give Angie a present? Yeah! Let's give Angie a present. Non-alcoholic drink of immortality. I feel like she'd be into that. A non-alcoholic drink based on a legendary alcoholic beverage said to make the drinker immortal. Neither grants immortality, nor does it taste good. I feel like she'd like this. We have four of them, so if she does, we can just keep handing them to her.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I see. This is an offering. This offering will earn a Tua's favor somewhat, Suichi.
Prayer time.
I pray to a Tua for you, Suichi, so that you may become a gold member someday.
Hey!
I can't tell if that's her really liking it or not. Angie, you have an interesting name.
Eh? Huh, really? Is my name so strange?
No, not strange, really. Are you not from here?
Angie lives with a Tua on a divine island paradise.
No. Oh, right, but where is the island? What's it like?
So divine!
It's a tiny divine island. It used to be much bigger. But Atua used a natural disaster to make it smaller because he thought it would look cuter.
That was the reason?
My island has lots of plants and flowers, too. You know
what? Sometimes I even forget that she's a sculptor. I forget that she's a sculptor sometimes because she never really talks about it. Oh, is that so?
But most of the plants and flowers on my island like to attack people. What?
They attack people?
I don't know.
Come to think of it,
I'm honestly not sure if they're actual plants or flowers.
Huh? What? What kind of island is this?
It's a dinosaur.
So divine!
A peaceful one, probably. What do you think, Suichi? What kind of place does my island sound like to you?
She answered my question with
come
a question.
Come on!
If you get it right, Atua will bless you and I wish you divine luck.
She hasn't given me any useful hints, so I have to guess. A tropical island paradise?
I see
a tropical island paradise, huh? I sort of remember a place like that. She's
talking about Jabberwock Island, isn't she?
Jabba something island, I think.
Jabba what?
Atua has spoken.
Atua has spoken. He will not be satisfied with that answer. Hmm. No blessing for you.
I see. So where is your hometown, Angie?
So divine!
In the middle of the ocean, surrounded by water and nothing else.
Thanks. A solitary island somewhere, far out to sea.
But
I get deep sea deliveries all the time.
Deep sea as in submarine?
Yep.
Deep sea is a shipping website. They have all kinds of stuff. It's super convenient.
Oh, that's what you meant.
I don't know what you thought I meant, but I use deep sea all the time. I bet Deep Sea is an instrument of Atua because it made life on my island a divine experience.
Atua works in mysterious ways, I suppose.
Of course.
There was any right answers to those questions. I'll have to try and pick out the right ones from now on, because I really didn't know that. I thought it was just pick whatever.
Deep Sea is how I got new issues of my favorite magazines.
A
food, clothing, organ, meat.
How divine!
plus medicine, blood, and even children.
Wait!
Wait, are you serious? Some of that stuff is a little crazy.
How so? If it can be shipped, then Deep Sea definitely stocks it.
But...
Now, if they just stocked offerings in OOP Arts, that would be so divine. What are OOP Arts? What exactly goes on Angie's Island? Yay, friendship fragment.
Hanging out with Angie is the best decision. Every sentence out of her mouth is like something that she instantly thought of, didn't process it whatsoever. It's just like, yep, this is great. With only a slightly better understanding of Angie, I return to my room.
All right.
It looks like there's still some time left. Free time, let's go back and meet Angie again. Maybe I'll try and give her something different. Maybe I should try, I'm not sure if you guys would consider this cheating, but should I like save before I talk to someone and then like try to give them the perfect gift and the perfect answer? Or do you guys just want me to go with it because it doesn't really matter all that much? Like, I'm worried that I won't be able to max out some of the social links, let's call them, for lack of a better word. Yeah, it seems like this could work for her since she's a sculptor and all that.
Yay!
This is it, this is what I've been after. How did you know Suichi did Atua speak to you?
Yeah!
Good job, Suichi.
Yoo-hoo!
Hey, Suichi, I need your help with something.
Okay. I'd be happy to help.
Yay, thank you. Now then, I want you to help me look for something.
Me. That shouldn't be a problem. What are you looking for?
Yep.
A sickle.
Huh?
A sickle. That's worrying coming from her.
Yeah, a sickle. You know, a crescent-shaped blade wouldn't handle cut stuff easily.
What are you going to do with that? Mow the lawn?
That's not right.
No, silly. I'm going to stab it into my window.
Oh, great. The window.
Yep.
On my island, if you feel sad and lonely at night, you stab a sickle into your window.
That's an odd custom.
And then?
Anyone who sees it can't just ignore it. They gotta go console that person. They gotta do anything they can to console them, and I mean anything.
That's frightening.
So whenever I'm feeling sad, I gotta have a sickle ready.
Right. I see. Well, if you ever need anything else...
Anything else? No, nothing else comes to mind.
Divine.
You're so nice, Suichi. I bet you'll come console when I stab my sickle.
Huh? Not me.
Yeah.
I want to be consoled by you.
I see.
Yeah.
I'll teach you all my island's customs, Suichi.
You can't do that.
First, you're not allowed to feed children after midnight.
I've heard of a creature like that somewhere before.
Come on.
Because it's unhealthy and they won't grow up to be stable adults.
All right. That sounds reasonable.
And they have to undergo divine initiation ritual before they can enter adulthood.
A ritual? Like a coming-of-age ceremony?
So divine!
During the ritual, we perform an intense physical workouts. They all become adults at the same time and feel all happy and relaxed afterwards.
Huh? What?
How divine!
I haven't undergone my ritual yet, but I hear it's a divine experience.
I see. Happy and relaxed, huh?
Of course!
That's right. On my island, everyone shares in our fun. Happy times!
You know, it really doesn't sound like anyone lives on your island except for you.
At weddings, for example, after the bride and groom consummate their vows, the guests make their own vows, and then they consummate those too.
What? Everyone?
Thanks, be to Atua.
After a successful consummation, the bride is blessed with a baby. Of course, we all share the baby too, using a sickle.
Huh?
What the hell are you going to do with that?
Yeah, just kidding. We can't share a baby. We just share the bride.
What does that mean? That implies something way worse, Angie. This island has a ton of strange traditions. Angie, your island scares me. Angie's report card has been updated based on your experience with her. Do I want this? With more questions than answers, I return to my room. Hanging out with Angie is hurting my brain. Can I hang out with her more? I highly doubt it. Oh, I like how everyone's still in the same place. I thought, like, maybe they were gonna do something horrible to Kaede's doll, but no, it's still there.
This is an official announcement. For now.
Everyone is out now, on work duty.
Bedtime, Ursine.
Thank you, Monodom. Nighttime already? Today really flew by, too. As I lay in my bed, Ryoma's words came back to me. Reason to live. When I really think about it, what do I have? I want to see my family and friends again, but what reason? But is that a reason to live? I wonder how it was for Kaede. I'm sure she had plenty of reasons to live. That's the kind of girl she was. But why am I thinking about this? I shouldn't be thinking about this stuff. I know I need to stop thinking that way, but when I'm alone, I can't help it.
Damn it!
I couldn't find any other, Monokuma dolls, and I'm assuming that's because one of them in each chapter is in one of the minigames. Like, last chapter, there was one of them in Hangman's Gambit, and I didn't see that. With all my willpower, I forced myself to sleep. Is he sleeping?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's sleeping. He's out, he's out...
Wait, what? He's out-light-alike. You mean out-like-a-light.
More importantly...
Who cares? Just hurry up and leave the present so we can get out of here. Don't rush me. Jeez, it's dark in here. I can't tell which is which. They left something for Suichi? Why? College entrance exams are a big milestone. Wait, what is this scene? What is going on here? College entrance exams are a big milestone on par with finding a job or getting married. Are you examinees out there working hard when studying? Focus is most important. Boost your focus by throwing away all those comic books and video games. Oh, but Spike Chunsoft games are fine. They're specially made to improve your focus. And burn those pictures of your girlfriend. You have time to indulge in good memories. But make sure you don't go and burn your actual girlfriend, because you'll go to prison for that. Prison might help you focus, but then you wouldn't be able to go to your exams. So if you can't focus at all, it's also good to confine yourself somewhere and study. I recommend confining yourself in an enemy's base. The thrill of studying in a place where you might get caught does wonders for your focus. Oh, and I also recommend studying in a disaster zone. The thrill of studying in a place where you could actually die does wonders for your focus. This sounds like, I can't remember his name from the first game, Man, it's been a while since I've had to even remember the first game's characters, but what was his name? Ishimaru or something like that? I don't remember. Hall Monitor Man. Oh, I also recommend studying in the middle of your exams. The thrill of knowing it's too late to get any studying done does wonders for your focus. With my advice, you'll beat the competition, so get out there and do your best. Thank you, Monokuma. I'll go out there and become the best doctor in the world now. Oh, Hiro shouldn't be asleep on the job. It's pathetic. Huh? Oh, Monokuma's in my room.
Yoo-hoo!
Good morning, although it's technically still night. Do you feel rested anyway?
Monokuma, I just went to bed like 10 minutes ago. Christ.
Yeah.
Nice face, Suichi. You definitely look your best in the morning.
Too bad.
You could look better, though. I'm pretty picky about people's morning faces.
What are you doing here?
How rude. My time is very valuable, you know? Since you fell asleep still clutching the love key... Oh, whoa. I'm glad I bought this then. I went out of my way to come wake you. I really wish you were more appreciative.
Love key? You mean this thing I won at the casino?
Yeah.
Yep, I'll tell you how to use it.
How to use it?
Woohoo! That key opens the way to a very special place. A place you might have actually seen in the vicinity of a casino, hint hint.
Oh right, that building. I suppose it would have this kind of key.
Woohoo, you look like you figured it out.
Thrilling.
Good, a healthy teenager's brain is supposed to be obsessed with sex and lust.
Now then.
That key you got there should help you clear out some of those carnal desires.
Huh?
Are you starting to get worked out? Are you ready to let it all hang out? Ugh. Now then, please read the instructions.
It's time for the talk, the love key talk. This is a key that is used to unlock the love suite. When night falls, you and one other person will be invited to the love suite. There, you will be a part of that person's fantasy. Oh no. They will see you as their ideal and basically just swoon all over you. Think of it as kind of a dream that lets you escape this cruel, dark reality. That's why it's so important to play the role that person wants you to. If you do something that breaks character, the other person will wake up in anguish. And what happens there stays there. Memories are wiped when you exit. It's like a one-night stand within a dream. Probably best that you both forget it. Well then, that's it. Stay safe and enjoy. You seem skeptical. Why don't you just try it out for yourself then?
Go ahead, take that love key out for a spin.
Looking forward to it.
I love how Suichi's not saying anything, because if it was like really, if he really like stuck to his character, he never would even go in the first place. Now then, let's take a hold of you. It'll make you sweeter than the bear's honeypot. Do I get to choose? I watched Monokuma bounce away, stunned. The key felt heavy in my hand. Well, I suppose it couldn't hurt. Do I get to choose who to take? Would you like to use the love key? Sure. Oh, I think it chooses for me. Oh. This is, not quite what I wanted. Every time I come here, I play the role of their ideal, like some shared fantasy. I wonder what the ideal Ryoma is picturing. He seems embarrassed.
Hey.
Suichi, I've warned you before not to chase after me.
Huh?
What do you mean, chase
you? Don't you get it?
We're nothing more than a former tennis player and a manager now. We're just strangers. Manager? I must be someone that Ryoma knew while he was playing tennis. So in Ryoma's fantasy, I was chasing after him. This is all part of his dream. I can't ruin that for him.
I threw away my past.
We've got no reason to see each other. If you get it, then hurry up and leave.
Hey.
Do I need a reason to see you? It's not like it's dangerous to see each other.
Yeah.
Well, probably not anymore. The mafia I got tangled up with is long gone. Oh, so that's part of his fantasy, is the fact that the mafia is no longer like a deal. But I don't have a future anymore. You've got nothing to gain with being, or gain being with me. I'm not only... I want to imagine that Suichi does, like, this female voice. I'm not only seeing you because I get something out of it, Ryoma. Managers should listen to their players, you know? Oh, I can't deal with this. I'm saying I don't want to see you. Don't follow me. It's irritating. How could you say that to me? Why is Ryoma being so stubborn? I'm supposed to be his ideal. Perhaps he doesn't really want me to leave. At least tell me why you don't want to see me anymore. I deserve an answer. I'm not trying to make this hard, just I won't believe it until I hear you say it. What is it, Ryoma?
Jeez,
I try to push you away and you just stick to me. What a weird guy. Wait, he's even acknowledging that I'm a man. I'm gonna talk about my selfish wishes now. You probably think I'm a pain. And then you stick around anyway. You're just that type of guy. Well, now's your last chance to walk away. You're just gonna regret
no.
listening. I wouldn't do that to you, not after coming this far, so please tell me.
Then...
In that case, I'm going to be honest. I'll be okay as long as you're alive.
Huh? What do you mean?
You're someone who lives in the sun, a place that's beyond my reach now. Someone like you remembering me in the back of your mind, that's
don't
all I need.
With me.
So please don't worry about me anymore. Go somewhere far away and live happily. You telling me this makes me want to stay by your side even more. I knew it. I knew you'd say something like that. But all this makes it seem like I want you to chase after me. Jeez, how pathetic. But that's alright, Ryoma. Just be honest and tell me what you want. On impulse, I took Ryoma's hand in mine. I felt that if I didn't hold it tight, he would run away from me. I don't know what'll happen in the future, but I know I'm happy now. Ryoma's hand gripped mine a little tighter. They were smaller than mine, and years of tennis make them hard but strong. Suichi, why are you making these observations? Like, I understand you wanting to play the part in making your night or whatever, but you're making some very odd observations here that you don't need to make.
I've still got a ways to go, too. I ended up getting you involved with
me. Oh, please don't tell me it's been, like, voice acting this whole time.
It's all right. I won't run away. Ryoma... Please don't run away either.
Okay, I'll edit out my voice for all the parts that are being voice acted here, because I did not notice. Sorry, I have my computer volume really low, so that way I don't, like, there's no echo.
I wouldn't do such a lame thing now. It might have been a long time coming, but I'm going to at least say it properly. Shuichi, things won't be like before, but will you help me again?
Wait, I'm so confused. Is this guy... What did Monokuma even tell him? Like, I understand what's happening. The main thing is the fact that he's sitting here saying my name. But it's not, like, what did Monokuma just say? Like, go live out your weird sex tennis fantasy with Suichi. And he's like, alright, sounds fine to me.
Yeah, of course. If there's anything I can do, I'd be more than happy to.
Is that so? Then, to make sure you don't regret your decision, I'll do whatever I can for you too.
All right. I'm counting on that.
I had done all I could. I held Ryoma's hand safe and warm. That was it. Obtain new theme, love suite. You've acquired a new theme, love suite. Giving it up at the hot. So, do I have to get one of those before every single night to get all these events? It takes a while to get that 10,000, though. Like, it literally took me like 45 minutes of pressing triangle at the slot machine to get that much. Rise and Shiner sign.
An official announcement, so then.
Yep. Wonderful announcement, Monodom. I can't believe this is your first time. This isn't really your first time, is it? Hey, is this really your first time?
This is the first time.
Oh, you're blushing. How cute.
More importantly...
Anyway, we dropped off some presents in your rooms. Cower in fear, because hail starts here.
So long, farewell!
What? Is it morning already? Last night with Ryoma, was that a dream? I feel like we discussed something important. A present? What does that mean? I swear, this is like a portrait of Kaede. When did this get here? It looks like a monopad, but it's not. It says Cubs Pad on the back in fine print. Cubs Pad? When I touched the screen, the device came to life and started playing a video.
All right! Back by popular demand, it's time for the motive video!
What? Kaito Momota's motive video. Oh, jeez.
Who's the most important person in your life? And now, without further ado...
Kaito?
Oh, what? Oh, sad. Oh, that's super sad. His parents are all excited to see him. Or his grandparents are super excited to see him go off into space. Kaito?
Kaito Momota! The ultimate astronaut! Thanks to his exceptional talent, this young man is already an astronaut trainee. Wow. Our team has managed to score an exclusive interview with his grandparents. They miss their grandson terribly and hope he returns to them safe and sound. But don't just take my word for it. Let's hear it straight from the source.
Are you serious?
Kaito, as long as you're alive, I don't need anything else.
No matter what happens, you must live. You must never give up. Please, live on, for our sakes too.
Their only wish is for Kaito to live. Will Kaito be able to fulfill his grandparents' wish? Ah, yes. One more thing. Shortly after this interview wrapped, these old farts suffered an unfortunate accident. What kind of accident? It's a secret! Find out for yourself!
So that's what it is.
Huh?
What was that? So the motive is Kaito kills someone so you can figure out what happened to your grandparents or whatever.
A
motive video? Could this be another one of Monokuma's motives? Even if it were, why do I have Kaito's motive?
No.
I'll think about that stuff later. I should hurry and tell Kaito. Round the hallway on a mission to find Kaito. I'm pretty sure everyone got this, perhaps. I'm not sure. I should try Kaito's room first. Wait, couldn't this be cleared up if every... Wait, so if everyone got someone else's motive, wouldn't that mean that if we just didn't show anybody, like, each other's motives, there wouldn't be an issue? With shaky hands, I press the doorbell. No answer. Did he already leave? In that case, he must be at the dining hall. Try there. Kibo, you know anything?
Kibo!
Kibo, have you seen Kaito? Impeccable timing, Suichi. I was on the way to get you. You were?
Please.
Everyone is gathering in the dining hall. Please come right away.
Yes, that's it.
Oh, go get everyone else. Thanks, Kibo. Everyone, what about the videos? I should go to the dining hall. Kaito must be there. What's going on here? So glad we can go in through this back door now. It's so much more convenient. Kaido's not in here. Kaido's not here either? Hey, has anyone seen Kaito? You seem in a panic over the Cubs pad, if I'm not mistaken.
Huh?
What?
You're not the only one who got one, Suichi.
Uh-oh.
We all did.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
We have all been given motive videos. However, they have been mixed up. Mixed up. When I woke up, there was a Cubs pad in my room, but the video wasn't even mine. Tsumugi, we should discuss this at once. Everyone is here. Oh, sorry, you're right. What do you mean, once everyone is here? Kaito and Kibo went to gather everyone else so that we may discuss our plans.
Yes.
Shall we wait for everyone then? Until then, I can provide you all with messages or massages. Everyone's already here. Damn, I won't get my massage now. Thank you for waiting. We gathered everyone else.
Oh, dear.
My word, and after I was about to finally experience one of Kurumi's famed massages. Could just ask for one more. You're in our ultimate lab earlier. Are you too nervous?
What is it?
Well, what do you mean? Are you also suggesting that I cannot read the air? So what is it? Why did
Come
you drag
on,
us here?
Man.
Didn't I tell you it's about the Cubs pads? Monokuma gave us a new motive. We can't not talk about it.
So?
That thing that looks like another monopad, that was a motive.
Huh?
Maki, you haven't watched the video on the Cubs pad yet? No, I ignored it because I figured it was something stupid. That's actually really courageous in a weird sort of way.
Hey!
Wait, you don't have to speak up, but this is important, so you should at least listen. So, what are these videos? No doubt they're more motives for Monokuma, but why are they all mixed
up?
Yeah, why go into Kitsumugi's video?
Hey!
No, don't say it, Gonta.
Huh?
I heard it, I see, so Gonta has my video.
What happened?
Huh? Gonta not supposed to say it? Who fucking cares? We're gonna exchange them anyway, right? No, we cannot exchange them. What?
Why?
We can't. Why not? Their videos are the most important people in our lives.
No.
And that's precisely why we cannot exchange them.
Listen closely.
Although we do not know why our motives were mixed up. As long as we don't exchange them, we don't have to see our motives at all.
Then...
So it's better just to ignore them. Yes, at least that is what I think.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I was thinking too. That's true. If we ignore them, then we won't have a motive. I'm against that.
Why?
Huh? Against it? Why? If you see that video, it'll turn into a motive, right? That's why I want to see it. You do.
Always messing around.
You're all saying something like that before, that you don't plan on surviving. It might not matter to you whether you get killed or not, but we're different. We all want to live. Wake up already. You're like some zombie wandering around with no will to live. No will to live, huh? If that's how you see me, then so be it.
Not cool.
But I've got no plans to change my opinion. That's just not cool.
What
did you say?
Mm.
Who cares? Ryoma just stated his opinion.
Because?
Actually, I feel the very same way as him.
Kokichi.
No one cares how you feel, Kokichi. Are you trying to cause trouble again?
That's so mean.
Don't get the wrong idea. I'm not saying we shouldn't care about killing or dying. But I think it'd be better if we didn't cooperate with each other. Actually, we definitely shouldn't cooperate with each other.
Why?
We shouldn't cooperate? Why not?
Because?
Think back to all Monokuma's actions so far. Whether we tried to work together, Monokuma would retaliate with a plan to make us suffer. It happened when Kaede wanted us to cooperate, and again with these motive videos, right? Which means the more we try to cooperate, the more he'll try to make us suffer.
Then?
You're saying that if we do not rally together, we will not be made to suffer.
I'm disappointed.
That's why I had no choice but to screw with you guys, but you ingrates didn't even notice.
That's...
And you're not lying to us right now?
Well, you know.
Whether I'm lying or not, what I'm saying is still true.
You know.
Anyway, we shouldn't just force ourselves to cooperate. Let's all do our own thing. So I agree with Ryoma's suggestion. It's because we're trying to cooperate that Monokuma's making us suffer? But what about everything we went through? What was the point of Kaede sacrificing herself?
So that means...
Anyway, I'm warning you all for your sake. Let's just exchange our motive videos instead of cooperating with each other.
Incomprehensible.
But isn't that cooperation if we're exchanging things that could get us killed? Wait, that's... Wait, what? I cannot comprehend that logic. Well, now that I've said I won't cooperate, I can't afford to be seen with you losers. Come on, Gonta, let's go. What, Gonta 2? We promised to think of a way to get everyone to exchange their motive videos, remember?
So that means...
Anyway, Kurumi, I'll hit you up later when I'm feeling hungry.
Huh?
Wait, did Gonta make promise?
Actually...
He's so confused. Why can't you tell when he's lying, Gonta? Quit screwing around, Ursake. Yeah, right. I've had it with his lies.
Well,
so are we all done here? Then I'm leaving. Kurumi, bring me my dinner later. Jesus.
Hey.
I'm heading out too.
Hey.
Wait up, Ryoma. I'm guessing the bring me my dinner later line isn't a coincidence. I bet she's trying to exchange the video with Kurumi and she actually did watch it. Don't forget, we're all struggling to get out of here alive. So don't get in our way.
Jeez.
I've got no intention of getting in your way. I'd never do something so uncool.
By the way,
Kurumi, could I get you to clean my room later?
Actually.
Oh, wow. You guys were relying on Kurumi too much.
Agree.
I do not mind serving others. Is the true desire of any maid. You shouldn't spoil people, though especially degenerate
in
males.
Any event.
Our cooperation is the number one factor in our suffering, isn't it? I wonder how will this turn out. I will observe with great interest.
I shall observe.
Oh, and Kurumi, I shall have you record my observations. I trust you to do it properly. I'm certainly not going to hang out with a bunch of chumps like
that
you.
That being said...
Guess I'll go back, take a shit, and get some sleep. Kurumi, think of an invention for me, okay? How much is everyone going to depend
it
on Kurumi?
Troubling.
My workload has increased significantly. This calls for a more tactical approach. Come on, you can't spoil them. They'll just turn into ungrateful leeches.
Eh?
What's wrong, Himiko? Are you hungry?
Right!
And how about we eat together? Kurumi, one tripe hot plate. Hot pot, please. Tenko, you're giving her more work.
Himiko?
What's the matter, Himiko? You don't like tripe hot pot? You don't get it, Tenko. Himiko isn't hungry. I know because I have the almighty Atua. Whatever, let's just enjoy some tripe hot pot. What is with you in that singular dish?
Jeez,
you're so careless, Tenko. In the end, those of us that stayed behind had tripe hot pot. God, I'm getting tired of saying that word. For a quirky take on breakfast. We also promised not to show each other the motives. The fact that Kurumi's going between so many rooms is going to make this complicated when someone dies, isn't it? Too much breakfast. Anyway, it seems like everyone wants to do their own thing. What can we do to work together as a group? I wish I could do something on my own, but that's impossible. If I screw up, it'll just be like Kaede all over again. I did it again. I can't keep those thoughts out of my head. I can't stand around doing nothing, I promise her. Oh, shoot. If we have another free time, I don't know who I'm going to hang out with, but I think this means if I want to get the cutscene or the midnight thing again with the key. So to get one of these for every single night, you have to grind a lot. Angie, you're eating food with Himiko in that really tense room. Himiko seemed really down. Angie and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give Angie a present? Yeah. She really seemed to be down with the mannequin, so we're gonna go for that again. I'm not sure if they care if you give them presents that they've already gotten once before.
Yay!
This is it, this is what I've been after.
Blah, 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 blah. Yep. What is she doing?
Oh, act.
Making a bunch of weird sounds I can't, like, replicate. Angie was making brush strokes against a canvas, accenting each with a sexy moan. Wow, Suichi. Didn't expect you to describe it that way. She looked like a woman possessed as if being puppeted.
Jeez.
Angie?
Huh?
Suichi?
Are you okay?
Are you okay? You look like you were hypnotized or something. I was worried.
Atua!
Yeah, I'm okay. Atua came down from the heavens and filled me with his holy presence.
All of my work is created in this manner.
What a surprise!
But I'm surprised. Atua usually doesn't come down in front of others, you know? Maybe Atua revealed himself because you're a chosen one, hmm?
I was chosen?
Yoo-hoo!
Hey, Suichi, look at this picture.
Okay.
I cautiously glanced at the painting Angie had just finished. Is it gonna show us? In an instant, I felt my consciousness slip away like a candle blown out by the wind.
Hello, Suichi, are you okay? Are you still with me?
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. I felt like I lost consciousness for a minute.
It'll be okay.
It's okay, I don't mind. This sort of thing happens every now and then.
What happens every now and then, does it? Art is sure difficult to understand.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's what everyone else says, too. Even so, you felt it with such intensity that you fainted, but you're okay now, right? Yay, I'm so happy.
But...
Still, it's rather strange that you fainted when Atua chose you.
What exactly does chosen mean?
How divine!
It means you were chosen.
Well, yeah.
I see.
Still, I think you're somewhat lacking. You're not quite divine enough. Atua agrees too.
Not divine enough?
Because Atua is watching.
Very well,
over
by
us.
Atua's divine decree, your training begins today.
Grinning ear to ear, Angie skipped over me. Over to me and... Whoa.
Me, oh my.
Why are you running, Suichi?
No.
I will have you.
You grabbed me all of a sudden. You tried to take my clothes off.
Yep.
Of course. How else do they provide what you're lacking?
It'll be okay.
I think I'm okay. Thanks anyway.
Wait, what? Of course. How else would I provide what you are lacking? Is she talking about what I think she's talking about?
Because Atua says so.
Why are you afraid?
I know.
Atua and I will gently embrace you.
What does that mean? What are you going to do?
Huh?
Wait!
I just wanted to talk, Angie. Just be friends.
Ah.
Oh, sorry for yelling. I just...
But...
I'm just worried about you.
Ah.
Angie? Oh, she... Okay, that was weird. She was not into that at all. Angie took off in a sprint and I couldn't catch her. This is bad. I bet she's really mad at me. I highly doubt she's mad at you, Suichi. She's probably just had an idea and went off to go do it. What am I even supposed to say? I'm sorry, Angie. I should have just let you molest me. I don't know.
Hey, what's up, Suichi? Just having a chit-chat with Himiko.
Should I hang out with Angie for a while? She doesn't seem angry over what happened last time.
She's like, hey, what's up? Yeah, I forgot about it already.
Maybe she go back to the store and try to get another mannequin. Where's a sketchbook? She might like that. Angie and I grew a little closer today. Would I like to give her a present? Sure. I don't know, Angie's weird. Thought maybe she'd like the monkey's paw.
I see.
I see, Sweetie. You know how Angie is feeling today.
Yeah.
With all the offerings you brought me, Angie must be having lots of fun.
Yeah.
I will be happy.
I know I yelled at Angie the other day, but I wasn't mad at her. I need to apologize. She'll probably turn me down, but...
Yahoo, I wonder what we'll get up to today, Suichi.
I thought she would be too mad to even speak to me, but she's not acting any different. All right, time to apologize.
Sorry.
Angie, I'm sorry that I yelled at you before.
Why?
Huh? Why are you apologizing?
It'll be okay.
I'm over what happened. Even Atua forgives you.
Atua did?
Of course.
Yep.
But what about you, Angie? Are you mad at me?
Why?
My feelings don't matter. Atua has forgiven you, so it's fine.
Hey, Angie, what is Atua?
Atua is a god, and God is Atua. He is always with Angie.
Yeah,
how divine.
No.
Right, but...
What?
Do you want to know more about Atua, Suichi?
Yes, I do want to know. You literally just say his name and scream all over the place.
It's okay, I'll teach you, but only you, okay?
Smiling even wider than usual, and Angie sidled up to me and spoke in a low whisper.
The truth is, my works are divine messages from Atua. Huh?
Divine messages?
Yep.
As an oracle, I can only receive Atua's divine messages.
She's an oracle, huh?
Hmm.
An oracle? She definitely does look possessed when she's making her art. Could it be?
And that's why it's my duty to tell everyone on my island about Atua's teachings. Atua's words are absolute, so everyone listens to anything I say.
Huh?
Anything?
Of course.
Anything. One time Atua suddenly told me to throw a big festival. Everyone on the island attended and we partied all week long.
And then?
It was so much fun, but since no one worked for a week, I kind of messed up our lives.
But
Atua told me to do it, so that's that. Atua gets lonely pretty easily.
I don't think so. I think Angie's the lonely one. Angie believes that Atua's will is her will. That means that everyone will listen to her. That means that Atua will take care of everything. But that's not right.
Yoo-hoo!
Hey, Suichi, what's up? What you thinking?
Too close.
Because
I want you to focus on me. Now I can see myself in your eyes.
Wait!
Hey, Angie, back up a little.
Why?
What? Why?
Why?
Why? Why? Why?
What do you mean, why? You're really close to me and...
So divine!
I don't mind. I want to be closer to you. Yeah, there, now you're closer to me.
I don't mind being emotionally closer to you, but can you scoot back a bit? Angie's report card has been updated based on your experience with her.
Cool!
We only have one more thing to hang out with Angie. You get to spend some time being close and getting closer to Angie.
It is now
wait, you guys turned the room into a kitchen? This is the official announcement from the Ultimate Academy. It's now 10 p.m. The late night special at the exclusive Monocob kitchen inside the dining hall is...
I'm whipping up a rice bowl with chicken, egg, and spicy kimchi. It's only 1,000 calories.
Only.
It's easy to make. Just cook fried chicken and eggs with rice. Top it with kimchi. Oh, and don't forget the mayo.
Voila, bon appetit.
By the way, this here's for Monocubs only. We ain't sharing any with you. Spam! How you like my culinary chaos?
So long, farewell!
Okay, then. I wouldn't eat that greasy food even if they threatened to kill me. Anyway, nighttime already, huh? When it gets to be nighttime, I start thinking about things. Was there really no way to save Kaede? I ask myself questions like that. Because no matter how I think about it, what happened to her is my fault. Huh? Is someone there? The doorbell's ringing. Kaido?
Yo!
Hey, come hang out with me for a sec. Huh? Now, but it's nighttime.
Come on, man.
There's no rule about walking around at nighttime, right?
Huh.
Be waiting out in the courtyard.
Wait!
Is he gonna murder me? Wait! But Kaido wasn't listening. He turned and quickly walked away. The courtyard at this time of night? What does he want? Could it be about the motive video I have? But how does he know? Wait, should I even go at all? Something might happen. Oh, what are you doing outside, Torikiyo?
Oh?
Are you going out, Suichi?
Okay.
Yeah, Kaido asked me to come meet him.
Yes.
Yes, I saw him near the Wisterius. So it was you he was waiting for. But having a secret meeting at a time such as this, do you intend to exchange motives?
No.
I don't know, maybe. He just asked me to meet him, I don't know why.
I was merely joking, however.
It would be understandable for one to come to that conclusion, please keep that in mind. What, is he looking at that thing? Oh, yeah, it's his lock he has.
Well, since I have witnessed you here, I suggest you avoid taking any foolish actions. In any event, good night.
Bye, Kyo. Don't worry, you're next on my list to hang out with. Now I'm even more worried. Something could happen to me. It's Kaido. I doubt he'd just, like, flat out murder you. Honestly, Kaido, for some reason, is one of the people I doubt would murder anyone the most. Why is everyone outside?
Yeah.
Hey, Himiko.
Neo, it's you, Suichi.
Hmm.
What are you doing up at this hour?
Neo, just thinking. It's pretty late now. I think I'll sleep well tonight. If I knew it'd be like this, I would have had her undo my brainwashing a long time ago.
Your brainwashing?
Well, good night.
That was ominous. What was that about? She looked happier than usual. I wonder what happened. Hey, Angie, what you doing outside?
Eh?
Huh, Suichi, where are you off to at this hour?
Well, I have something to do. What are you doing?
I was just praying to a two and... Yeah, just be excited for tomorrow.
Huh?
Tomorrow?
Sayonara.
Good night, Suichi. See you tomorrow.
Don't you dare do anything. Don't you do a thing. We haven't finished hanging out yet. You are not allowed to murder or die or anything.
Yo!
Oh, good. You came. What's wrong, Kaido? Did you call me out here? Why did you call me out here all of a sudden?
I mean...
See, since I've chosen... since I was chosen as an astronaut trainee, I've trained every day, but... I haven't done any training here at all. At this rate, I'll get all week, so... Join me, Suichi!
What? Why me?
Alright!
Doesn't matter, let's get started. Take off your coat! What? Why?
Shut up!
Instead of complaining, just do 50 push-ups. I don't know how it happened, but before I knew it... Oh my god, Suichi! You are stronger than you look! You're stronger than I am! Probably, well, not physically, but... Jeez! I was doing push-ups with Kaito in the courtyard in the middle of the night.
Why do I have to do this?
Now's not the time to use your head. Now's the time to move your body. What's the matter? Slowing down already?
I never do push-ups. My arms are giving out.
Hey, don't say that. The impossible is possible. All you gotta do is make it so.
What the? That logic makes no sense.
Somehow I managed to do 50 push-ups, but my body was spent. I collapsed on the grass, panting.
Jeez, that's pathetic, man. Getting tired from only 50 push-ups?
Got it.
Well, that's enough for now. We'll pick back up tomorrow.
Huh?
We're doing this again tomorrow?
Huh?
Well, yeah, you gotta do daily training every day, right?
But
why do I gotta do this, Kaido?
I mean...
Because this training's for you.
Huh?
For me? When I look at you, I can't help but get frustrated. I ask myself, is the one Kaede entrusted your wish to really this weak?
I mean...
You've been holding yourself back since then, haven't you? Do you think Kaede died because you made the wrong deduction? Do you think you killed her?
Okay.
Yes, I do, Kaito. Because of my detective work, she set up that...
Dumbass!
What are you saying? That was all her fault.
Listen up.
Her sins and her regrets are hers alone. You'll only make her worry about you by trying to bear all those by herself. I know.
Damn it!
I know that. I already know that. You don't have to tell me. But I can't help it, Kaido. I can't stop myself from thinking about what I could have done.
It's no use.
I'm scared. I try hard not to be, but I'm scared. I can't stop thinking about the pain and sadness that comes if I reveal the truth. That's what I'm afraid of.
All right,
I got it. So that's your enemy, huh? Enemy?
I mean...
Well, you gotta deal with your worries yourself. I can't give you an answer for those, but...
you know.
At least you know you're weak, as long as you can admit
that. Let's do it!
Then you'll be okay. You just gotta train and get stronger.
Huh?
Listen up.
Training is the only way to overcome your weakness.
But
in my case, getting stronger is more of a mental concept.
Don't worry about it.
Your head and body are connected, right? At the end of the day, they're the same. What does that even mean? He's not making any sense. But maybe that's exactly what I need right now.
Okay.
Alright, Kaido, I'll try.
No.
I mean, will you let me? I want to train with you, Kaido. To get closer to defeating my enemy.
Well said,
bro, but I'm strict, so you better prepare yourself. Bro, huh? That's the first time he's called me that.
But,
perhaps you should be training too, Kaito. You talk big for a guy who only did 20 push-ups.
What?
You were counting?
Jeez,
you even noticed that. I guess you are the ultimate detective after all. But you know, my goal was just 50. Wait, was just 50 anyways. Doesn't matter if I'm a few short. Well, that's not fair at all. Unless Kaido and I began our training regimen. I don't really know why Kaido is so concerned about me. But I suppose I can trust someone again, just this time. I decided to trust Kaido and his craziness. I think Kaido's gonna live till the end. That's one of the people I feel who's gonna make it. It's gonna be Kaido. I'm so tired. I worked out for the first time in a long while and completely exhausted. It's a good kind of exhausted. Alright, for now, sleep. I didn't have any intrusive thoughts that night. As soon as my head hit the pillow, I fell into a deep, relaxing sleep. Okay, so I'm gonna end the episode here. I've been actually recording for 2.5 hours. I got so into playing this game, and I had to reload save so many times to get to this outcome. But I hope you guys are enjoying the series. I'm really liking hanging out with all these people. Talking to Angie's so much fun. I better not wake up to her being dead tomorrow, because I am one event away from, like, getting to the end of Angie's craziness. Now I have to wait. I hope you guys are enjoying the video. I've been thinking about extending these videos and making them a bit longer. I normally have videos between 50 minutes and usually 50 minutes, an hour, and 10 minutes, but I'm thinking of making them between an hour and 30 to an hour and 45. So tell me what you guys think about that. I hope you guys are enjoying this, because I had a hell of a lot of fun with it. And if you like the series, please leave a like. I'm sorry once again that I kind of fell ill and had to postpone this for a while, but... if you liked the video, please leave a like, and if you want to become a member of the Dust Brigade, just click subscribe. Thank you, and see you on the next episode. Riding out.